So today we're making C stirrups for the lintels over the doors and windows. Now I didn't have a chance to get all my engineering done before I ordered them. I ordered all the C stirrups pre-bent for my decking on the floor. But for all the windows and doors, it's going to vary a little bit by floor and location with the sizes. So I've calculated that now. I'm at that stage of the house. I'm now going to make 170 of these. I find that it's better to do it in a mass production style. So I've got a stop here set up for my Berner Newman cold cut saw to cut these into the exact length. And I've got a setup down there where we're going to mark out and bend for the actual bends. Now this section here is a little bit longer than I'd like, but that's the shortest section that my bender will do. All right, we've got my jig and my stop all set up and ready to go. So let's cut some pieces real quick. In my case, I need 8-inch long stirrups. So it happens to work out that my steel is going to be 16 inches long in length. Yours will vary depending on the diameter of your bender and other things. And just like that, in just over a minute, goes a 20-foot piece of number 3 steel. All right, I'm down here at the other end of the table. I've marked on my table here the exact lines that I'm supposed to cut the bends. I'm going to smooth them all out, even them up. Got a quick straight edge here. Now, since these are controlling the distance of the reinforcing rebar, spacing is kind of important, so I want to make sure I measure that and get it right. My bender can do two at a time, so I just grab two of them, line up the marks here with the marks on the bender, pull the trigger and let it do the work. Flip it over, I've got two more done here. I've got a pattern that I've drawn out right here on the table just to check. Every new batch, I check it just to make sure. You don't want to make 170 just realize you got it wrong. I do find that I prefer bending these two at a time. That's the maximum capacity of my bender. Not only does it get down a little faster, but because they're next to each other, it helps keep them straight, and I don't tend to get them bent cattywampus. So the idea is you put this down in there, you'll hook the bottom bars, pick it up, and set it over top of the top bar. Now, depending on your window and your schedule, you might have to do it every 6 inches on both sides of the window or the full length. That's given in the build block prescriptive engineering tables.